Welcome to Godwin Tech. In this video tutorial, I'm going to walk you through on how to use a computer that runs Windows 11 up. When you power on your computer, you are going to arrive at the desktop section, which should look like this. Okay, so this is how the desktop section will look like. Then from there, you can get to different parts of your computer to change some things. Okay, so for example, now if I want to change this background image, let me start from there. How do I go about it? Click on the search app, pin at the taskbar, and in the search section, I type change background image or picture. Okay, the background image. All right, background image. So type background image. So this is the background image settings. Click on there, and it will take you to a settings page that will allow you to make the changes you want to. Okay, maybe you feel like the popular background is becoming too much, so let me use something unique. You can go to this, maybe this is what you want to use. Click on that, and the background image of your Windows 11 computer will change. So let's minimize it, or let's close. Once you close, you can see the background has changed now. All right, let's talk about taskbar. Maybe you want to pin an application on this taskbar. How do you go about that? Click on this search app, which is optimized. Then type the name of the app you want to pin to that taskbar. Let's say Excel. All right. So this is Excel app, which is already running on this computer. And I want to pin it to the taskbar of this my PC. The next step you have to take after the app has shown up is to right click on it. So when you right click on it, okay, it's already pinned up to the taskbar. If it's not pinned, okay, it's not pinned to the taskbar. So select the option to pin to taskbar. Okay, then this app is automatically pinned to the taskbar. You can see it here, Excel. All right, now what if people want to make some other customizations that have to do with taskbar? For example, now I want to shift this key, these apps that are the taskbar, to the left, which is the default settings of other versions of Windows. You know, Windows 11 comes with a new arrangement whereby the start button is pinned at the center. So what if you want to make the changes? Right click on the taskbar section and select the option to manage taskbar. That's taskbar settings. Okay, click on that. This will open a taskbar settings page for you. So on that taskbar settings page, we can make a lot of changes we want. Maybe you want to turn off some taskbar items. That's the apps that are pinned at taskbar. Example search. Turn it off so that it stops showing at the taskbar here. Which just has been turned off by myself. Chat and the rest. Okay. So on that taskbar behavior, that's where I want to draw your attention to. You want the start button here to go to the left. So what you do under the taskbar behavior is come to this section that says taskbar alignment. Click there and select the option to go to left. You can see now these apps, these taskbar items now has been moved to the left instead of the center where it is by default. So I can just still change it back to the center. I like it having it at the center. All right. The next thing is on how to scroll on Windows 11. I would like to explain that using a page I have already opened in the web browser. Then for example, now I want to scroll down this section. What you need just to take your cursor to this section, then you scroll down. All right, scroll down, scroll down. You can see you can scroll down, you can scroll up here. So bring your cursor to that section, then you scroll to any part you want to. All right, if you want to still scroll in this section, take your cursor here to this section, then scroll down. All right, you want to scroll up, still scroll up. That's it. So let me minimize it again. Then there's something we called layout. Okay, if you want to maybe show all the items that are open on your computer, understand, you can take your mouse here. You can see as soon as on layouts, you can snap layouts, you can position this window, this browser app that is open. Let's say I want to position it here. As you can see, it has shift to this section, and I'm being shown some other parts of this my computer that has apps open in it. So I can click on any of them. For example, now this is the Chrome page that is open. This is highlighter. This is the settings page. So if I want to go to this settings page, I'll click. So it shows so many applications that are now open on my what? Computer. So that is that. So let me go back and then teach you about other things. So here, let me talk about how the major folders in Windows 11. Okay, some folders are created by default in Windows 11, and for you to access these folders, click on the file explorer, which is pinned at the taskbar. You can see that. So once I click on it, the file explorer will open. And with the recent update in 2023, file explorer now has home. Okay, so look at home. Now I'm on the home section now. Okay, now the major tabs, the major folders that are created by default on Windows 11 are desktop, downloads, documents, pictures, music, and videos. These are the major folders that are created by default on this PC. Okay, then if there are some other folders you access frequently, they are now positioned in the same line of the quick access section. This is quick access section where the major folders appear, because Windows developers understand that if you are accessing a particular folder frequently, that means that folder is important to you. So they feel like, okay, it's necessary to have some of these folders pin here, so that once this young man or young lady opens the file explorer, he can access the folder so easily. Alright, that is by the way. Then what if you want to create a new folder inside any of these folders, how do you go about that? For example, now desktop is a folder created by default. If I want to create a folder inside of it, I'll click on it, the folder, the major folder for it to open. Then the next step is click on this new button, select folder. Type the name of the folder you want, the name you want to give to the folder, maybe good, anything at all. After that, hit the enter key, and the folder is created. Okay, so these are just the steps you need to take to create a folder in a computer that runs Windows 11 operating system. All right, so now if this folder you created now is already on the desktop section, because this is a desktop folder, so if you want to create folder in other major folders like documents, pictures, and the rest, still do the same thing. Now what if there is any folder you have created on these major folders and want to pin it to the quick access section? Is it possible? Yes, it's possible. For example, now I'm in the documents folder. Let me go to the document folder, and it happens that I access this folder with the name blog post. I want to pin it to the quick access. How do you go about it? I'll right click on this folder, and then some options. Okay, click on it first of all, then right click on it, and then you see the option to pin to quick access. I'll go with that. So once you do that, you can see this blog post has now been pinned to the quick access. All right, so these are the quick access sections of this file explorer. So that is that by the way. So we close it. Then how do you access applications that are existing on this Windows 11? It's simple. Click on the search app pinned at the taskbar by default, then type the name of the app you want to access. Example, paint app is one of the default apps that comes with Windows 11. So this is the paint app. Click on that paint app, it will open. Okay, So these are how to access applications. See, it has opened, but I don't want to do anything on it now, so let me just close it. How do you view all the apps that are installed on this computer? It's simple. Click on this start menu and then click on all apps. So this will open a page displaying all the applications that are existing on this computer. Okay, so these are just the few steps. We can do a lot of things. Okay, accessing settings. If you want to access the settings, let me stick over that. Click on this. Then the next thing you do is under this, you can see a place called pin app at the start. So click on the settings icon and the settings page will then open. So that is that, by the way. Then if you want to uninstall an app, maybe there's an application that is existing on this computer, but you don't need that app any longer. How do you uninstall it? Click on the start app, type the name of the application. Let's say which browser, or let's say which application do I want to uninstall here. Okay, let's say what? No, what is not okay. Let me view all apps. Let me from this, I will get to the app I want to uninstall. You can still access the app by clicking on the start menu, as I've done now. So when you click on the start menu, then go to all apps. So they will show me some applications that I may not necessarily need yet. So I will click on going down, keep on going down, maybe until I get to the application I feel is not necessary. Okay, WhatsApp. Do I have WhatsApp here? Yeah, okay. Let's say this WhatsApp app, I don't need it. I will right click on it and select the option to do what? Uninstall. This will show up on my screen. Still click on the uninstall button again. All right, so this application will be uninstalled from this computer. So these are just the few steps you need to take to make use of your Windows 11. Okay, some other videos that are not covered here, I will cover them individually, but I believe this will keep you up and going on how to use a computer that runs Windows 11 operating system. Please do well to subscribe to my channel by clicking on the subscribe button. Just click on the subscribe button, you are good to go. All right, like this video if it helps you and leave a comment. Thank you and see you next time.